Hello and welcome to Dell's Gaming. I'm Dell and this is From the Depths and the campaign map as we left it last time. So as you can see, we've had a bit of a move around. And before we get started, I'm gonna change the way the videos are working and the way we're gonna send up videos based upon a couple of things. One is what I actually enjoy doing in these games and from the depths and just generally videos in general. So it'll be a combination of that as well as what I think would be good fun thing to do and I don't see a lot of other people sometimes doing. Okay, so what is that? Right, the thing I like in the game is building things. I like building shit basically. It's good fun. Oh, we've got a zone there with nothing in it. Oh well, never mind, eh? So I like building things and solving problems. So what we're gonna do is I've split the group up into there's effectively gonna be four different fleets. And we're gonna give each fleet, basically, each video a battle. And I'll cut down the video to the highlights, and if it's an uninteresting battle, I'll move them on until they get a good battle. Where the two things I'm looking for, which makes an interesting battle, they come across a problem. And they get a lot of damage and don't do very well, or it becomes a bit dodgy. So that's a problem to be solved. Or we're seeing if a solution we'd previously put in place works on a battle. And at the end of each battle, so the fleet will have a little analyse and then possibly go and build something or spend some time thinking about and building a solution for this particular fleet. Now, what I'm going to do though is separate it up into different fleets. So we've got different sort of solutions to the same problem potentially. So starting off, we're going to have the Turtle Fleet, which is going to have this northern sector at the moment. They're going to sort of make their way up this northern edge to a degree, or come in a little bit then go north. We'll see exactly how I'm going to use them exactly, but that's their main aim at the moment. So there are surface ships. So I've taken out all of the flying ships, except the good old pursuit turtle pursuits, which like to fly on occasion, that they are restrained airships really, I think. So they'll be our surface ships and we'll bring in some ships and find solutions which are suitable for more surface-based ships. And then we've got our avian fleets. Now it is at the moment three different fleets, although one needs to join up with, I think it's this one here. Let's put him over there so he can join. So we've got the avian claws, which were a good surface vessel fleet. We have the we've got the condor fleet, which is very good against big targets, and then we have our sea carrier, which will be our flagship sort of fleet for that, and that's going to be our aerial group. So when we put them, we'll be looking for solutions for air vehicles for any problem type of ships that they come across. So that's our second one. The third one is, certainly not the least, it's one of my favourites, is the Aquanauts. So that's the subs. I've taken out everything. They are now just purely subs with extra subs for good measure. So they're a sub fleet. And so any solutions for them will be underwater based. Now, at the moment, I've got them near a landmass, but I'm going to try and keep them attacking more open water areas, so we may change around. If we've got a very heavy land section such as this one here that's coming up, we can't quite see it, I might swap in one of the other fleets, but generally they're going to go up. Now the fourth fleet is going to be a work in progress over time. Is I've brought up the Atlantis, and this is going to be the fortress based one single really big massive kick-ass sort of ship. Well, it's fortress, not a ship. Basically just to make it big, simple as that, where it's not going to have any other thing. It's going to be one vehicle. We might use sub spawners and stuff like that, but even they will be static spawns that it brings in. So this is going to be our fourth interesting fleet, and we're just going to see how big. It's going to ignore all block counts because it's going to be a single vehicle that gets spawned in. each time, it will be the only vehicle that gets spawned in, therefore everything has to fight it. So it's got survive, it's got no speed, can't go underwater, can't go high, can't go fast, it's just got to beat anything. So it's going to be our single super behemoth that goes against the ship. So anyway, that's the idea for the way I'm taking from the depths. In the videos themselves, I might use a bit of time lapse in occasion rather than commentating on every single bit, or cut to commentary, which I think is interesting. Looking at the comments for time codes for any big battles, for interesting wire classes, interesting points that might come up in the comments, etc. Might make some for shorter videos, but certainly I'm hoping interesting is the important part. So that all said, let's go kick some butt. Right, the Onyx Watch are our next enemies that we are going after. So the first thing we need to do is go and declare war on them. So if we take that off in there and go in here, we can see, what we've got. Deep water guard, 0%. White flyers, 0%. That's good. So Onyx Watch is going to be our next faction. So let's see what we've got. We're suspicious. I can declare war. That might be the easiest way to do this. That suddenly means that basically they're not going to like us. Why change a habit of a lifetime? And who else is going to be? So that we might have a problem with the. Who's that? I get confused who they are. Twin Guard. Okay, we might have some problems with the Twin Guard over this, but ultimately, nah, who cares? Declaring war, seeking reprisal, there we go. And we've also got them, but we're gonna actually give, they're dead. We haven't got to bribe them. We might bribe them a little bit. Let's give them a bit of crystal. There we go. Bribe them, there we go. So they're suspicious, they'll stay away from us. So just the Onyx Watch now we have to deal with. Simple way there, give them some crystal, everyone seems to be happy, yeah, for you, as long as you don't muck around with them. Okay, now I wouldn't be surprised if they start trying to send things against our resource zones, which is one area we're going to use our aerial fleets to try and tackle any ships that come up. Okay, so this is going to be our first little battle. So let's see where we get to in here. Speed it up, let's see. Now I know that I think there's a whole load of sailing ships. There's a furnace here, whatever the furnace is. We don't have to take on a furnace. You know, I thought, you know, we're gonna be looking after the Twin Guards, the Onyx Watch's heating bill by the sounds of it. All right, let's go straight for them. Now, we're gonna use the tactic, since we're subs, of stopping a little bit before and launching our ships. And what have they got? There's a whole load of ships here. Let's see what we've got. We've got a Bayleaf. Oh, there's just lots of ships here. An Alcazar, a Palisade, a Meridian. This is gonna be a Stockade. They may even get a certain points advantage, but we're gonna bring in what we can early on and see what we can do. Right, let's get a little closer before I launch our ships. And then we're gonna go for, see what our subs do against these little enemies. Right, that's very close. Right, let's stop it there. We're very close to starting start to go in. Oh, it's just starting to go to night. That's not handy. Not handy at all, I say. Right, let's go let's go to my guy first. Right, go up here. Right, we need Leviathan in. And I'm gonna bring in some of the deep water people. Right, that's Leviathan in. Okay. Scout, Tempest Destroyer, Walrus. They've got no aircraft, so I'm not gonna worry about the Seagull. Maybe the Sub Seal Hunter. Let's see how that comes up. Might bring in the other SEAL Scout as well. So, okay, hopefully nighttime will disappear before. We've got a few problems. This is the only problem. We've got some vehicles which are close to the land. Just got to hope that if they do need to come in, we're not landlocked. That'd be just very annoying. Okay, so this is giving a chance for my subs to get underwater. We'll leave them in there so we can see when battle begins. There's quite a few flipping ships up there. I hope these subs are up to it. We shall soon find out whether our subs... Oh, they've got a fair bit of a points advantage there. But they haven't taken out our ships that are already in game. Yes, we've got to do a fair bit of battling here. Now, as long as the Leviathan is in... Yes, can't bring anything else in. But it hasn't taken out the ships I'd already brought in. So this is quite a big little battle. Interface off. We're going to see how we do. Okay, so starting point. We'll have a look at some of these ships, because we haven't seen the, for this series anyway, the Onyx Watch ships. And I don't know if they've changed them. I know some of the other people have actually done some battles against them. Excuse me. So you might see some of them. Palisade by any chance? Looks sort of Palisade-y as such. I'm going to bring the interface back on here because I hate trying to do this without the interface on. Alright, info. That's the... Oh, it's a rampart. Okay. Okay, and over there, is that another rampart? Let's have a look what you are. An hourglass. Oh yes, I remember that thing, because it's called an hourglass, but to me it used to look like an hourglass, but it doesn't anymore. There used to be a clock it used to look like an hourglass. Unfortunately it's changed a lot since then. It no longer looks like an hourglass. Okay, we have plenty of missile spam coming in. So that's some new ships. Let's see how this first strike does against the Onyx Watch. The Leviathan is coming in with a serious grip of missiles here. There's some serious missile spam coming in. Okay, so serious launch of missiles here coming in. Are we integrated now? Yeah, I'm integrated. Ah, it didn't seem to make a difference. Oh, they've reduced the tails a little bit, but that's a little bit better. A little bit better. Not much difference. Just the tails on the ships, and we've got, what else have we got coming in? We've got a few missiles with proximities on coming in, but not too many. I used to have proximities on just about everything, but I know that did cause some problems. So okay, they're going after this hourglass first, by the looks of it. So this is a nice strike opportunity for screenshot. Yes, they're definitely damaging him. We have all types of goodness. Let's get around the other side where they're actually doing the damage. See if we can see it from the other side. Oh, you can see some of the... Yes, I did put EMP in some of these. Explosions with the EMP. He's yes, here. I don't think he's going to be enjoying this the next few minutes. That's definitely seeing a some pain for him. Excellent. Nice to see. I do like the big boom, as we all know. Big boom, important. Yes. Good set of missiles coming in there, so okay, that's good. His first strikes are exceeding quite nicely. And he's also someone, or possibly the Leviathan, is even going in for this here as well, the parapet. And he's got some big guns as well, but luckily they're not that effective. And you, just the skiff, just, yeah, don't even think about it. So, okay, there's a couple of ships. Let's just back out, let them get destroyed. Hopefully that hourglass will not be lasting much longer. And we have a new ship deciding to spawn in. And what have we got here? Let's bring my interface back on, just so I can use the Q menu properly, otherwise I can't see it. Looks like a big old bugger, this does. And this is a Stockade. Oh yes, I remember these Stockades. They can be, well, they're big, as you can tell. You know, there's a lot of points there. There's a lot of metal here as well. Now, one of our subs did seem to get a bit close to the surface here for some reason. Not sure why that is, but he's a, yeah, he's a 5,000 block ship, so he's not small. But yeah, one of our ships did seem to, I don't know if he turned over or something, but he seemed to get the wrong way up over here. We'll just go and have a look, see what happened to him. Is he going down again now? Yeah, he just seems to have got the wrong way up for some reason. One of our eel scouts got twisted. So unfortunately, I think he's gonna get seriously hammered at some point. I obviously didn't build any self-righting mechanism, but he's still firing torpedoes. So he's still doing some damage, although I'm expecting him to get a bit of receive a bit of damage in return, but we'll see how he does. But at the moment, we took out the hourglass and the rampart, and there looks like, oh, there's something else has come in as well. What have we got down here? Let's have a look. Just to confirm, although he seems to almost be being shot by his own side here. That's a culverin. I will not remember that name. Not a culverin. The Leviathan is doing a nice bit of damage against him by the looks of it. That's coming in quite nicely. I think I need to find out who's firing all of the missiles with proximities and remove some of them. I think that's what's causing the slow up, but we'll go back into time lapse in a bit. He's doing a fair bit of damage. He seems to be, he's blowing up his own ship. Look, you're destroying your own guy. See, that we're supposed to destroy them, not you kill your own people. The Onyx Watch are a team of a bunch of team killers. That's what their problem is. What can you do? We haven't got to go far. First, you know, I get enough of that in a World of Tanks and World of Warships, team killers. Don't need it in From the Depths from the AI as well. Oh well, there's torpedoes going in. They seem to be doing a good little job, which is not bad. And now we've got a whole group, a nice sheaf of missiles coming in here quite nicely. Yes, that seems to be doing reasonable damage there. No complaints there. I think that will be good. Okay, we'll back up from the battle a little bit and just see what we can do against these various ships. Whoops, got one over here as well still. That's another culverin. I don't think the culverins are lasting very long. They're not really that much of a thing. You can see one of my ships down there. That's the deep sea destroyer. He's getting right underneath. and welcome back for a bit from the time lapse. And one of the reasons I realised this is so damn slow is from the beginning they actually pulled in their fortress. So my the Leviathan is now sending his long range missiles against the fortress, this furnace. So that would have been one of the reasons that we're getting some problems, I guess, because this is going to be one hunk of a chunk of vehicle or fortress. Let's have a look. 7,000 to the furthest. Let's go and have a look at it though, because not really had a look around. We've got a fair bit of lag. We'll see the how the Leviathan does at trying to take this bugger out. I can say one thing for certain, he's big. He is certainly a big old boy to take out, but we do have missiles incoming. We'll see if those long range missiles make it. Leviathan's got some very nice, tasty long range sticks coming forward. As you can see there, they fire at a fair old distance. And only long range targets and only big targets. So we'll see if that can do some serious damage to this furnace. Hopefully the my cinematic moving around of the camera is not unenjoyable, but let's just now watch this hopefully getting destroyed by the Leviathan. Thank you. Well, whilst we were watching the furnace getting bombarded by the Leviathan, looks like a couple more ships have come in. One of them looks like a halberd, I think it is. And I'm sure he was actually putting out smoke there a second ago. And the one at the back, that sailing ship, which is a little bit outclassed just at this moment, those sailing ships, I think might have been a Meridian as such, potentially. So that could have been what was just brought it in there. We'll just verify that. If that is a halberd, it's not a halberd, it's something else. But it actually has, from memory, has LAMS, laser missile defense system. Glaive, okay. Yeah, rings a bell now. Rings a bell. Glaive. So, okay, that's an interesting little one that's come in. Now, I have tried to take out some ships, which I think might be giving us some of the problems, the ones that are producing all these ships with the proximity mines, but obviously it's not done it yet. I'm just going to go to the map and see if I can find out which ships are where. From here I can't really tell which ship is which, actually. Nothing's coming up on any of them, which is just annoying. Nothing. Okay, can't do it that way either. Okay. Okay, we're going to go for... Leviathan's doing quite well on his own at the moment. So, I'm going to take out everything that's not a Leviathan. Not the Leviathan. Maybe ones that I'm not certain about. We'll take out him. The other ones I'm happy with. It could have been one of these Seal Scouts. One was upside down anyway. So, we'll see what it's like with just Leviathan and the Walrus, the ones that I know are good, reasonable ships. Okay, let's see how they're doing against this furnace. Serious amount of missiles going into that furnace, including torpedoes, missiles, big missiles, little missiles. You name it, they are going into that ship, into the enemy fortress. It's just sheer size now, and I think it's not improved a lot, but it's improved a little bit maybe. So we've taken out a good portion of this vessel. Let's just have a quick check of how much of it is left. Yes, we've taken a good 2,000 and something blocks out of it, which is good news. All right, we'll turn that off again and we'll just see it take out the rest of it, hopefully. We'll be right back. Okay, well, finally that glaive is now AI dead. So now we got to see what else spawns in. Our ships are doing reasonably well. Standard set of ships without the DSVs. We're doing a lot better. So I will go through them and modify them, but and I won't bring them back. We'll see if we bring them back. Good set of missiles going in against this wooden ship, which is excellent. To be honest, missiles versus wooden ship. Yes, I'm not really expecting great things from him. Yes, yeah, that's definitely going to be bad news for him. What would be really nice is if in the earlier parts of the game you were given the sailing items and it was actually made sense to build nice big sailing ships like this of some description, because it was either resource wise or in some way beneficial. I just think it'd be nice to see some big sailing ship battles. Or at least big wood ships. I think we've got some explosions happening around here somewhere. Excellent. This is definitely feeling the pain now, and yep, we're getting some block counter back. We haven't got anything else spawned in at the moment. Oh yes, we have something else spawned in. What have we got over here? It's firing whatever it is. It's decided it's got something it can shoot at, and what is this? It's got one heck of a broadside. Excuse me whilst I do not go broadside to this thing. It is the Clydesdale. What was that number of points? 9,000 blocks. Some rather large and interesting guns on the rear. And, well, obviously all along the side here you can see there's some very high gauge guns he's trying to bring into the broadside, and also on the front. He's got a bit of a gun on there as well. If they hit you, you will know about it. You do not want to get close to this ship. Right, let's see these missiles going in to the buttress. And then we'll see what they can do. Oh, though they're actually already retargeting by the looks of it. Some are going into the buttress, which is good. We've still got some missiles with the proximities on Leviathan by the looks of it, so I will go through and take them off. Two damaged. Okay, so it is now this Clydesdale is our target. Okay, now we've got... Ooh, this is a big bugger. This is one big bugger. A bulwark. He's going to take some pounding. This is going to be a while. He's got a lot of guns. Frame rate, even with him. Oh, how many blocks was he? Let's see. Blocks. Nearly 15,000 blocks on his own. Oh, sir, you're a bit big, aren't you? You're one mamma jammer, aren't you? Still, we shall see how you do against extensive missile spam. Because the Leviathan is very good at bringing down upon the enemies the righteous missile spam from the depths. So let's see, we've got missiles coming in. Missiles inbound, sir. Significant worm sign, or in this case, significant missile sign coming in, sir. Can they take out these turrets, or are they actually going to completely miss? Because at the moment, I have no idea where these missiles are aiming at, but they do not seem to be aiming at this, which is somewhat of a problem. Oh, they're coming down now. They're a little bit late on the whole firing thing. But this could be good. This could be a nice down on the top, at least protected, or they could totally miss. Going for 50-50 here between missing and being a good hit from the rear. Or that could be interesting. They're all hitting behind it. I hope it hasn't got a little bug where all of them aim at a spot just behind him. That will be annoying. That'll be rather annoying indeed. I'm not sure whether he's got any, if these are radar, whether he's got any decoys. But these ones are coming in quite nicely. So there's obviously some of the laser ones are coming in a little low, but they are coming in. There's a bit of a log jam over here. A missile log jam. They can't get out of the water fast enough. By the looks of it, he's gone a little bit deep, I think, the ship at the moment. He's taken a fair bit of damage. I wouldn't be surprised. How much damage is he down to? Oh, no, he's perfectly healthy. So he isn't even damaged. So these are now coming in quite nicely. So we'll go back here and watch this, hopefully getting pummeled a little bit by missiles. And that Bulwark took a long time to be finally taken out by our massive missiles. So what have we got now coming now? Another new ship, not seen before. The Palisade. I have to remember that with all of those ones. So that Bulwark was a big ship, 15,000 blocks in one ship, and it just took a lot of pounding with everything we had to basically take that out. Got there in the end though. I've got to say we did manage it. It's not a problem. We got there. It just took longer than expected. Okay, the Leviathan's now having to go at this Palisade. Good little ship by the looks of it. Interesting. Again, got a broadside effector. Not sure if that gun's... Oh yeah, that gun's been damaged already. Not as powerful. A little paddle gun. There, little paddles to push it along. Interesting ship, as always. Although I don't think it's going to last as long as the Bulwark. And I honestly hope it doesn't. So, we've got some serious missiles coming in. I quite like the downward arc some of these missiles get when they get that right range. I think that's excellent. It comes down straight on top. Don't always get that. That's good. 600 meters. Yeah, when they get in that 600 meter range, these particular missiles are very effective. But when it's near that 900 meter, the missiles don't quite have that same punch, because they've got to have obviously a lot more fuel on board basically. But at this range they come in very nicely. I don't know if you saw, hopefully the cinematics were okay. There was a lot of torpedoes coming in on that Bulwark. And this has done the same. The lasers are aiming very low, which is making a lot of the missiles hit early in the water because they're trying to go so low. I need to check to see whether I've got aim point, but it's obviously aiming for the engines, which are, I'm guessing, quite far underwater maybe. Let's have a look. Where are these laser beams going? They're going straight through here somewhere. Maybe in here. Oh, I don't know. Where's his engines then? They could be going for those ammo barrels there, I suppose. But let me get out of here a second. It doesn't matter because we've got so many missiles coming in. I think eventually we'll get through there. But we need some, I'm thinking some sniper missiles. I'm going to have two possibilities. One is some... We'll analyse it later. We'll analyse what the issues are later with our subs. For now, it's coming up to darkness again. We've done all day on this particular battle, I think. Let me get to a point where we can see this Palisade hopefully be taken out by more missiles. And we got rid of that Palisade, and now we have another new ship, and this is interesting. It has anti-missile defenses, this one. So what have we got here? This is the Alcazar, a 12,000 block ship, and he has lasers, but has he got enough lasers will be the key. Seems to be doing quite well so far. This could be an interesting challenge for our ships. That's a significant number of anti-missile defenses coming in there. But we also have a significant number of missiles coming in. So, yes. Yeah, that's not too bad. That Palisade was also causing a lot of slowness, but we seem to be a lot better now. This is going to take some time again to wear down, but let's see how we go. It's like a light show here, firing away all these missiles. But we are doing damage. Our missiles are getting through. We've already done a load of damage to the front, and if we can start taking out some of these the missile defense systems, then obviously we can do even more damage. And the one area he's not going to be defending against is our torps. Hopefully our torps should still be coming in, although these ones seem to be... Oh yeah, no, they are coming in. They are coming in slowly and steadily against him. So we've already done a bit of damage on the front. And have we got more? We've got more coming in. So we are doing damage. Oh, look at that. Taking a nice wodge through that side part there. Excellent. There's a lot of, you've got a lot of gap in there, but let's see how, if we can get some missiles through this disco light show. Disco. Some of our missiles seem to be going off aim. Don't know where they're intended to go. Is it potentially he's hit one of our designators? And our ship's still perfectly healthy, so they've just gone, for some reason those ones have all gone off aim. It doesn't like coming over this way for some reason. Are our missiles still getting through? No, they seem to be all over the place just at this moment. Torps are getting through, but some are definitely having a problem. But a serious number of torps are getting through here. So these torps are just coring him a bit. Frags and explosives just making their way through him. So that's excellent news. Excellent news. Right, so whilst they're doing their job, we'll go up and watch Disco. See how long it takes for him to get destroyed. We've got some missiles coming in. No, not all of them. Most of them are getting destroyed now. But, okay. Let's see how long this will take against our torpedoes. I'm going to have to do most of the damage here. And that was another long block bash, but finally got through it. So now we have, well, hopefully we're down to the last few ships with any luck. We've got this, the Bayleaf Refit, which is a nice another 8,000 blocks, mainly wood. So I'm honestly not expecting this one to last too long, not against the missile that is coming through here. So yeah, that was good. That previous one, I've forgotten where it was. No, it wasn't the Bulwark. That was a mean ship, but it did eventually go. It just obviously a lot of blocks to work through before it would sail. It took a bugger to sink as well. You know, even putting holes in it through most of its hull, it would not sink. Considering the amount of metal that was in that, I'm bloody surprised, you know, it wasn't sinking sooner. Eventually it did, but I think it was a good 50% damage before it was sinking. So credit to the designer of that. That was very buoyant for a whole load of metal. That was very buoyant. I'm guessing there was one or two pumps involved. So this one is already below his 80% in sinking, so that one will be out of the game soon, with any luck. So we've got, I think we've only got a couple left. So yeah, the Bayleaf really a little outclassed in this particular. So we've got two more large vessels of, well, we've got about 11... Yeah, we've still got quite a bit of points-wise to be pulled in. So we just got to wait for this Bayleaf to be eradicated. We're over a million metal now, so that's very good. That leaves us plenty of room to bring some large ships in if we needed to. Okay, 1 second. He should be disintegrating anytime soon. No time warp, time lapse required on this one. See, that's the way I'd like to see these battles, but that's not always the case. Some of them are taking a little longer. I think he's disintegrating now. I think I can see blocks disappearing. Yep, right. We're not taking very much damage at all. In fact, we're still at 100% of all the ships that were actually in the battle. After I took out the deep sea vessels, which obviously got a lot of proximities, which I need to go and adjust, and I'll bring them in. But we might modify them before I bring them back in again. But we'll see. We'll see. Okay, next ship. Tag in your next, in the next partner. Come on, tag him in. Tag him in. But if we build ship, we've got to make sure that our other ships are able to take some on some of these very large vessels. And we got another Bayleaf. I think that's another Bayleaf beam fit. With any luck, or it could be a Constitution. No, Bayleaf beam fit. Okay, Bayleaf beam fit, and repeat. The got a significant number of missiles coming out there, just to say hello. Say hello to 16 of my little friends. And the other guys are firing as well. That could be his side torpedoes. And that looks like that's from the walrus over there. So everyone's coming in with a significant number of missiles. performance wise we're fine here with this number of blocks. So once I get rid of some of those proximities, I'll keep a few of them but get rid of most of them. On a few they're still handy. You can see the side launched missile. Just go and have a look at the Leviathan for a bit of, so you can see how, for those that haven't seen it for a bit. So this is my Leviathan sub. As you can see, there's quite a few missile bays. What you can see coming out the side there is the side launch torpedoes, which are down here somewhere. Near the front, I think. Yeah, that's the front side launch torpedoes. Got some of those on each side. And then you have all of your vertical launch, various vertical launch missiles on the top. With in recessed, except for that rear one, generally in recessed bays. And yeah, reasonable amount of shielding, as you can tell there. It has been taken out by some ships, so it's not impervious at, by any stretch of the imagination. It is in, it's quite possible for it to get taken out, and if they hit some of the vital areas on it. So it's a good ship, but not impervious. Okay, so I think we've got one ship left. Yeah, so whatever this is here is going to be our last ship. I'm guessing. Come on. Come to Daddy. It's Johnny. Come on. You know you want to spawn. You know you do. Given our systems a chance to build up a little bit of ammo. So we've done 10.5 million damage and 7.8. So I don't know what the difference between the two is. I don't know if that's explosive and fragmentation, but yeah, we've done a fair bit of damage in general. Okay, so the Bayleaf is now finally sinking. Dun, 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 dun. You are done. Dun, 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 dun. And what have we got coming in next? Now, it is a big square. Now, that's a big hunk of metal that's coming in here, I think, for the final. It could be another Alcazar Disco Inferno. Or it could be one of the Bulwarks, or I don't know. Yeah, the Alcazar was a pain. Once we did start taking off the anti-missile system, it was fine. Just took a little bit of time. Time, that's all. Just time. Well, there goes that. So, okay. In we come, in we come. What are you going to give us? Here he is. Here he is. And it is another Alcazar. Let's make sure there's no differences, but I'm pretty sure. Yep. Alcazar. So, here we go. Disco, disco. Get those lights burning. Disco, disco. Disco Light Inferno. Yes. I don't know where these guns at the back are firing. I don't think I've got anything over there. Yeah. Maybe I have. Maybe I have. I'm not aware of anything of mine over there. Oh, we have got something. What is that? That is... can't seem to select it. Hang on a second. I just want to see what this is. Seal Hunter. Okay, I'm not sure why he's all the way over there. Anyway. normally it gets a lot closer to the enemies than that, I thought. But let's watch the disco info. This will be the last long battle, hopefully. So we'll just, once those torpedoes start coming in, you've got very good LAM system this has, as you can tell. Very nice. Taking us out quite happily. But generally, the torpedoes are coming in and they're taking out the front of his ship. And inside is a lot of area, put it that way. So it's just a matter of all these torpedoes which are coming forward here, especially working their way through these ships. And they are doing it, they are making their way through. So I do send out a significant number of torpedoes, as well as the thing. You can see them actually down there. A lot of these, I think, are torpedoes waiting their time to hit the front of this ship. If you see a trail behind them. Oh no, some of these are missiles that have just died early, and not torpedoes. In Terra torpedoes, they have a little trail behind them, as well as in the back, there's a little torpedo propeller type thing. Looks a little different to the thruster. But we're doing quite nicely. We're taking out the sides of this ship with the torpedoes. You can see it tell the frags as well are making their way through the sides. And if they can get these, you see it, nice little ammo barrel, if that could be taken out by a torpedo or two. Would be that whole section removed, just about. Okay, disco, disco.
Yeah.
Okay, well, finally, he's sinking. I don't know how many blocks we did actually have to take off of him eventually. Let's just have a look. We had to take about half of his health, just under half, about 40%. So that's a lot of blocks we had to take before we started being classed as sinking. Torpedoes helped a lot against this Alcazar. Normal missiles, I think, would have a problem. So it'll be interesting to see how the avian and PT fleet deal with when they see this particular monster, because he's got a lot of missiles there. But this should be the end. I don't think there's any more to spawn in. Let's just have a look. So come on, there we go. There's no more. So once he's gone, that's the end. Okay, we've done, I don't know how many, is that 11.9 million damage in this. We've got up to a million in our metal, which is good. So I'm just gonna go here because there's a few bits and pieces I can do ready for when we're afterwards, maybe, if I can get some response. We'll bring up our resource zone, if I can select it. We've still got a few lag issues. There we go. He'll be going into that spot there, which will be very handy. Yeah, once this guy is taken out, and the rest of our fleet will. No, you're going there. This fleet. Click. Yes, there we go. You can go over here, and the DSV can join up with you once I have sorted out his missiles. Okay. So, just whilst we're waiting for him to disappear, I reckon that's about two and a. Looking at the recording time, it's about 2.25 hour battle. I'm going to use time lapse on this recordings and just stop it at particular points, and hopefully you'll like some of the cinematics or the bits that I have classed as being interesting. And I'll put obviously time codes in the down below for those interesting bits. Let me know what you think about the time lapse idea, whether that's good or not. Or whether I should just cut. And I like the time lapse. I think you see what's happening, and you can maybe see things I didn't see. There we go. That's cool. That's finished. So we will just check our fleet. Yeah, everybody was fairly much okay in that regard. Even the subseal hunter. I don't know why he went so far away, but I'll sort that out later. So, okay, we've got that zone. Now that was a large number, and the only other one that looks big, we've got another large one here, which we might put the avians into, or even possibly the Atlantis. We'll have a look at what we push forward in that regard. So analysis of what we're doing, what we could do better as a fleet. So they did well, generally not a problem. I think the fleet did very well. I'll have to work on the DSVs, get rid of their, find out why they were lagging, find any excessive items they were firing which were causing a problem. These big ships, okay, so what needs to be, we were getting missile hits in on them, which is good. What I think is needed is like a big hitting missiles, sort of the sub version of the Condor, something like that. So some very powerful cutting sort of missile that will just damage as many blocks as possible. Maybe a combination of torpedoes, big torpedoes, and big missiles, having a range of around 800, 900. And the ship just stays away, stays back, and just fires these big missiles at big targets, and that's all it does. Takes them out one way or another. And when we know we've got some big ships like we had there coming up, we can spawn in or have this in our fleet spawn list. So it's one of the definite ships that are spawned in, maybe sitting deepish in the water for its own protection. So we look at that as a possibly an ICBM type of submarine. So next time we'll have a look. It may be time for the avians to have a go, or possibly we'll bring in the PT fleet. I think we'll start getting the PT turtle fleet over into this 140. If there's some new items there that we haven't met before. But yeah, hopefully the new video format will be good for you. I might try something else with the other one, cuts rather than time lapse, but let me know what you would prefer or not, and hopefully click that like for us. It's always beneficial and appreciated. Subscribe so you know when the next one's coming up, but until next time, have fun.